And we're on.
It's on the stage that said, I was glad when they said, let us go into the house of the Lord. What an honor it is to be back together. So all of you here and together today, we're just trusting that the good Lord will grace us with his presence in a special way. I believe the Lord has a word for us today. How many of you believe that he still speaks to us? He still directs us. Amen. We want to look to the Lord and go to the Lord in prayer. Brother Jerry is running just a few minutes. Lady, he told me, he said, you might need to have a long prayer. So I said, okay. But we're going to go to the Lord and ask the Lord to help us today. And just to minister to these, those that join us on the web page or Facebook Live, whatever, there you join us today, just a moment to have you with us. Just trusting the good Lord will speak to your heart today in these times. How many believe we need to hear from the Lord in days like this? Amen. Even if we didn't have a day like the day we're living in, I still want to hear from him, don't you? I want to serve him in the good time and in the bad time, no matter what time it is. I don't want to live a second without the Lord. Praise the Lord. It's in him we move and have our being. Now let's look to the Lord and let's pray together that God will just touch us in a special way here today. Our gracious Heavenly Father, as we come before you, we are giving thanks and honor and praise, Lord, for your goodness and for your blessings and your love that you so graciously bestowed upon us, giving us an opportunity today that we can be gathered back into the house of God. Lord, I thank you, Lord, for each one that was able to gather today, those that are gathering with us, oh, Lord, on the web page or Facebook Live, whatever, Lord, means that they're gathering, Lord, with us today, we just pray a special blessing upon them and touch them. We pray the lost will be saved today. Our blinded eyes will be opened, Lord, to, Lord, their need for you. Just asking, dear God, Lord, those that are needing healing in their bodies. We know that there are many, Lord, who will be going, Lord, to prayer over those requests shortly. But we just ask you, dear Lord, to touch them. There are those that are there in the hospital that need a touch from you, nursing home. Wherever they're at today, your people, Lord, we pray, Lord, a special blessing upon them and in this service today. We pray that faith will rise because we know that all things are possible to them that believe. Asking you, Lord Jesus, to minister and meet, Lord, each and every need here today. And all that will be done and accomplished, we'll be careful, Lord, in giving you all the praise and the glory and honor for it's in Christ's wonderful name we pray. Amen and amen. He's here. Praise God. Amen. 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 The prayer was long enough. Amen. Praise God.
Good to see him. As they come. Boot them up. There we go. Yeah, just a little piece. There we go. And there's Brother Keith. Woo, Lord. Thank you.
Yeah. tombs, my doubts and thoughts I keep, and it cries all my fear. What a blood that gives me strength from
you. What an honor to be in the Lord's
always have. You want to go to the Lord in prayer, make your request before the Lord. Maybe you have it up in hand before you like to signify the day the Lord knows that you. They would make that day. You want to remember Sister Deborah Murphy in our prayer. The Lord continue to minister to her and touch her. Also, Brother Brian Yates there was in the hospital. He had an infection, staph infection, he said, I think somewhere as far as on the head. And then he had to take some antibiotics. And so there he called me yesterday and said he wouldn't be in the house. I'll be able to be here today there because of the medicine zone. Let's also remember Terry Hartley and Sister Magdalene Adams' family today. Sister Magdalene Adams passed away yesterday. So let's remember that family in prayer. I think my wife, she will share a little bit more about that, about feeding the family. Any other outspoken requests I may have missed? Yes, Sister Louise.
Don't you
also remember Sister Huffman in our prayer, Brother David said that she was given what the pain before she failed. We just believe in God. Anyone else?
Sister Odessa and
her family. Sister Whitlow, we want to continue to remember him. I look in our prayers, a number of others. Also, Sister Gina Allen, let's remember her. Sister Betty Lassiter, also Sister Ruth Jones, and others of our elderly that God put in ministry for them. Someone else?
Yes, I have one. A friend of mine.
Let's also, how many of you believe our president needs prayer?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Well, he's in under his prayers, also far as our nation, and all the division that the enemy is causing. Satan, you know what, I may be today bringing in a little bit of that, but I believe the enemy, Satan, is behind every soul.
Oh, yes,
Satan.
I do.
Yes.
I believe that. I believe I'll be able to show you that. Let's remember our nation and people that God will just minister to them especially. Anyone else?
Nowadays, it's scary to even have to go into the hospital. You look for help, but you can catch anything while you're there. So,
well,
please remember
Yes, let's thank you, Brother Chris. Our law enforcement needs that. How many of you know that, that Satan would like to be chaos?
Yes.
If you don't have law, that's what you will have. There's nothing but chaos. Amen. Anyone else?
Yeah. Brother, remember our church?
Yes. Yes, Brother. Let's pray for our lost family. We've got to get them in. Absolutely. Let's take these things to the Lord and pray together. But I need you to do this. Precious Heavenly Father, we come before you and we thank you, Lord, today for your goodness, for your love, for your mercy. Lord, we pray for our people. Lord, we pray for the church, Lord Jesus, today, and all those, Lord, that are there, that's joining us, Lord, on the web page, on Facebook Live. We're asking you, Lord, that you would touch them. All that would hear, Lord, the message today. Lord, I pray that faith will arise. And Lord Jesus, Lord, people will respond. They will respond, Lord God, to the word today. For faith comes by hearing and hearing by the word. Lord, as you administer to your God and to each one that's gathered here today. Lord, I pray that faith will arise in this place. I pray, Lord, for Sister Deborah Murphy. Pray, dear God, that you would, Lord, touch your Lord today. Bring healing to her body, we pray, in the name of Jesus. You're greater than shingles. We pray, Lord, for Sister Magdalene Adams, family, for Terry Hart, Lord, and the other sisters, and James, the brother. Ask you to touch them, dear God, and move that family, Lord. We pray, Lord, in this time. I know it's been a difficult time, challenging times that we're living in. But there's a God in heaven, hallelujah, whose ever eye is over your children. Lord, my God, never slumbers nor sleep. Your eyes over the sparrow, Lord. You see when that one that calls. And Lord, it does not escape, Lord, the Father's eye. Asking you, Lord, to lead this ministry, Lord, every open hand request in this place. And touch him, Lord, we pray. We pray for your content for Lord Jesus, Sister Louise, the request that you give in. For those residents there, Lord, we're asking you to touch them. Sister Lavetta Huffman, Lord, you would touch her, Lord, in her body. And Lord God, make her, Lord, whole. That pain that's in that gift, whether it's fractured, whatever, Lord Jesus, it might be, Lord, you're the healer. You're Dr. Jehovah Rapha. Let there be healing to flow. Lord, we pray for our lost loved ones, our families, Lord. They will come in before it's too late. Make them a calling election, sure. Children, son, we pray for Julia. Lord, we pray, dear God, that you would, Lord, touch her, Lord. These anxieties, these things that are coming, Lord. There's a God in heaven. Hallelujah. Oh, my God, ever watching over us. As the song said, I have a heavenly Father watching over us. Watch it over me. I'm going to give you praise and glory and honor for all the things that Lord has been accomplished in the service today. Jesus' wonderful, precious name. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Brother, Brother Shane, you can do that. Brother. Brother. I need somebody to let me know if you feel more comfortable about it. We can put a basket out there, and for you to do there, we'll put your offering in, et cetera. So we want to do that as long as possible. Yeah.
Thank you.
Worship Sister Tammy, she's going to go ahead and share. What? Oh, wait a minute. She's down here. I don't know what happened, but that's the way.
I'm on fire. Good morning, Sister Tammy Smallface this morning. I had a sworn announcement. I did speak with Sister Terry Hartley this morning, Sister Magdalene Adams' daughter. One of the saddest things to me this morning, as I was talking with Sister Terry, is that Sister Magdalene's son could not even be with his mom. She was in the hospital 3 weeks, and then she went into hospice. And the daughter was about to see her only for 2 hours, I believe, those whole 3 weeks. And when they put her in the hospice center, they begged him to allow her son to go in to visit with his mom before she passed. And they said, we will lose our jobs. He could not even be with her. So we need to pray for them for God to give them peace of mind.
Yes.
We can only put ourselves in their shoes on how they're feeling. But I know God can help them. God can give them peace. Sister Terry did ask. I told her that we would be willing to serve. So tomorrow, between 3 and 4 o'clock, we're supposed to be taking a meal. So if you'll see Sister Connie Van today, if you're unable to cook anything or bring anything, if you'll give a donation, then we can go purchase some items that we need. We're going to take it to Coates or Sister Terry Van's. If you're at home right now, make your arrangements. They are not, from what she was told, she's not allowed to have a visitation. So I will do a one call concerning the funeral. Some
startled, Sister Kathy. But they were not sounding to me like they were able to hear it. So I said, well, I'll give her a hot one. And when I did, she could tell. You have your Bibles, I'd like for you to turn with me to Luke chapter 8. Pray this week about Thursday, I believe it was, and the Lord just laid this on my heart. Never preached it before, as I recall on this thought. I believe it just speaks to us today in the times that we're living in. I believe the Lord, I believe if we'll hear what the Lord is saying, and you don't want to leave in the same way you come.
Amen.
I want to tell you, I want like Jacob. I want to climb up a little bit higher. Anybody with me?
Yes.
I want to get a little, I want to get a hold of the next whatever you call him, little heavenly
branch.
Whatever it is that you climb up on. Help me. Praise the Lord. I just know it's a ladder. Luke chapter 8, beginning in verse 22. Luke chapter 8.
Holla.
This story is in all four of the Gospels. And there's also another part when Jesus was out on the shore of the storm to come. Luke chapter 8, verse 22. Now it came to pass on a certain day that he went into a ship with his disciples, and he said unto them, let us go. I want you to underscore that. He said, let us.
Yes. Come on now.
If you think you're by yourself, you need to read that over and over and over until you get it in your spirit.
That's right. Amen.
Yeah.
You are not by yourself.
Right. Amen.
Let us go unto the other side of the lake. And they launched forth. But as they sailed, he fell asleep. Now he don't slumber or sleep today. I mean, you know, he's identifying his humanity. There came down a storm of wind on the lake, and they were filled with water and were in jeopardy. They came to him and awoke him, saying, Master, Master, we perish. Then he arose and rebuked the wind. That's the God man
there. Amen.
And the raging of the water. And they ceased, and there was a calm. Literally there, Mark and Matthew talks about great, literally a dead calm. And he said unto them, where, if you say that, where is your faith? Oh, that kind of sink in. Where is your faith? They, being afraid, wondered, saying, I would have been too. Well, they said right here, saying one to another, what manner, in one translation, Brother Smith said, Brother Mason said he done like this. Wow! What a man!
What a man.
That's what he said. That's what he said. What manner of man is this? For he commanded even the winds and water, and they obeyed him.
Amen.
I want to deal with the thought today, the Lord will help me. Oh, where is your faith?
Jesus.
Where is it?
Help us today. Jesus.
You help say us. You have faith. But where is it?
Help us today.
Now listen, now, y'all, anybody want to help me preach today?
Yes, amen.
Help us today, God. I'm not sure.
Bless him, Lord.
If you'll help me preach, then I go home with you equally.
Mm-hmm.
I want the Lord to help us today. How many of you believe if there's ever been a time God's people need faith?
Yes, yes. Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
Faith that overcomes this world
is
the kind of day we live. Father, I thank you for your goodness. Thank you for your love, your mercy that you so graciously bestowed upon us. Thank you for every family, every person that's gathered here in the house today. Lord Jesus, they are honored that they graced us today here with, in this place with their presence. Asking you, Lord, to minister, Lord, in a special way, those that are online. We're asking you, dear Lord Jesus, to touch those, we pray, in a special way. Lord, I believe you have a word for us, Lord, right now, an on-time word, because you're an on-time God. None of these things that are happening has caught you by surprise. In fact, you have already told us and forewarned us of what would come, and we are seeing it now coming to pass. And you said, when we see these things, that we're not to wring our hands and say, what are we going to do? But Lord Jesus, we're to look up, we're to trust you, we're to hold unchanging hand that we come to and have assurance of relying upon our Lord, who promised to never leave us nor forsake us, but go with us all the way even unto the end of the world. That each and every one that comes here today, online, I pray, dear God, you will minister to them. I pray for the lost. I pray for that son, that daughter. I pray for those, Lord, that are bound, Lord. There are people that are bound today. Lord, they don't know Lord Jesus, Lord, the right hand from the left hand. They're like those in the time of Jonah when he went into that city and said that, Lord, you were going to destroy that city in 40 days. I pray, dear God, that you would open up, Lord, their understanding of the times that we're living in, to make their calling and election sure and get ready to meet the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, who are about to step out on the clouds of glory and take us out of this world. I will ever give you all praise and glory and honor for that which will be accomplished, and all every soul that is saved, Lord, I'm going to give you the praise. Lord, you know I've asked for 1,000 souls to be saved to lay at your feet, and I'm going to give you praise for it all. I want to have fruit to lay at your feet, Lord. You've been so good to me. I'll give you praise for all that you have behind the cross. In Christ's name, we ask it all. Everybody said amen. 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 I don't know of any more important question to ask in all of life. And where is your faith? In Hebrews chapter 11 and verse 6, the Bible said, but without faith, say that with me, but without faith, it is impossible to please him. It's impossible to please God. For he that cometh to him must believe, or to God, must believe that he is and that he is a rewarder. In other words, the faith that once was delivered to the saints. We're talking about that kind of faith. We're not talking about some of the kinds of faith that's being propagated today. It's not in the Bible. I'll get into that in a few minutes. And then that diligently seek him. There are all four of the Gospels give us this story. And when you put them together, you have a most powerful picture of what our life is like here on the Sea of Life. And so this is an important here message for us to get a hold of. I think one of the most important, especially in our times, for us to reach the other side. So stay with me on this here, as we see here. This faith that I'm talking about under consideration in making it to the other side is more than just a profession. It is that there that was once delivered to the saints. And this faith that I'm talking about, I want to break it down and use faith as an acronym, and I want to deal with it in this manner. Faith finds God. Faith accepts God. Faith identifies with God. Faith trusts God. And faith holds to God. First of all, I want us to see that faith finds God. Notice verse 22, the Bible said, now it came to pass on a certain day. Now most all of us remember the day when the Lord reached down. You remember that certain day that the Lord found you where you were at. You say, well, I found the Lord. In reality, the Lord found you. He knew where you were at, and he went after you. Haven't you glad that a shepherd goes after us? He leaves the 99 that are whole and goes after the one that's gone astray. Anybody in here ever gone astray? If you don't raise your hand, there's something wrong. All of us, the Bible says in Isaiah 53:6, all we like sheep have gone astray, and the Lord hath laid on him the iniquity of us all. So we remember it like David when he lifted us up out of that hollow pit of sin. We remember when he took us to Calvary's bathhouse. Oh, come on, somebody help me. Oh, to that fountain of blood and water. And he washed us and he cleansed us of our sins. He took away our filthy rags. Isaiah chapter 64 and verse 6. And then he clothed us. Isaiah 61 and 10 with the garments of salvation and covered us with a robe of righteousness. In Ephesians chapter 2 on that day, he quickened us. That means he made us alive. He gave us life. Those who realized that they were dead in trespasses and iniquities, and they understood that there's only one person that can give life. Now, Harry can't give it. Buddha can't give it. Allah can't give it. Jesus Christ is the only one that can offer unto you and give unto you eternal life. Somebody got to help you in here. There's a reason we're not on the best that's going. Scriptures gives account of some who had tried to describe it sometime. Have you ever found it somewhat difficult? You found it to be inadequate to describe to others just how it felt when the Lord Jesus cleared you of the charge of quitting your job. Anybody understand what I'm talking about? You realize that you have broken the laws of God. And then when you were really godless off. Now please don't misunderstand here. When you come to the altar and there ain't no tears in your eyes, I got the problem. And I believe there's gonna be some sorrow there. You say, well, I can't cry, well, that may be a different thing. But I'm telling you, if you realize that you've broken the laws of God, there's gonna be some brokenness that's going to be there. But you found it somewhat difficult to be able to describe just how you felt, how some of us were further down than others. I want you to understand all of us were down. And we needed to be lifted up out of that deep, miry clay. The woman at the well who came with a water pot to draw water from the well, from that natural well. But she came, and there at that well she met a man by the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And she even made a statement there. What fellowship or what does the Jews have to do with Samaritan? But she found out that Jesus Christ in Luke chapter 19 and verse 10 had come to seek and to save that which was lost. I want to tell you, Jesus Christ came to save every color, every type of person there is on the face of this earth. And lift him up out of a hollow pit and set him on a standstill on a rock. Now you may slip on that rock, but if you'll stay on that rock will never go down. For that rock is Jesus Christ. If you found him. Help me today. So I can see here this woman when she meets Jesus who told her of her sins. Now that's very important for you to understand. Jesus started up a conversation with her, but he got around to her sins. I don't believe a person can get saved until you get them lost. And so we see here, no doubt she thought her sins were hidden. There's a lot of folks that think they got their sins hidden. But here Jesus exposed it, and then she found out that her sins were not hidden with God. And so there, after Jesus had confronted her with her sin, there we see her. She saw her need for this living water. Jesus offered it to her, and she cried out, Jesus, there, give me this water. Now I want to say here, after she met Jesus Christ, after she was confronted with her sins, she had five husbands. The one she was living with was not her husband. But then after she met Jesus there, she left her water pot, and she went into that town, and it was hard to describe. There for this lady here, only she could only tell the city. There after she had experienced him in John 4 and 25, she said, come and see a man which told the old things that ever I did. Is not this the Christ? I'm telling you, if you met the man from Galilee, Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, I'm telling you, he's going to confront you in your sin, but he's not going to leave you there. He's going to pick you up out of that heart of the pit, and he's going to give you life and give it to you all the time. You will not be the same after you made Jesus. Jesus don't leave you the same.
That's right.
Amen. Oh, Sister Williams, that's what that son needs. He needs to experience the lifting power of Almighty God. It doesn't matter what kind of storm that you're in, but God, I'm talking about it. He can come along and he can lift you up out of it. He can stand on the bow of your boat and say, peace be still, and there will be a dead calm. Amen. So those who truly find Jesus because of him. I want you to understand something of it. The reason you come to Jesus is because of his law.
That's right.
Come on.
Bless the Lord.
There's a lot of preachers in the pulpit that never even mention God's law. You see, we're not under law. You know, a man needs to know he's under it there until he comes to Jesus.
That's right.
Anybody understand what I just said?
Yes.
Galatians 4 and 24, the law was our schoolmaster to bring us to Christ. Yes. Let me tell you something else. you understand you broke the law of Christ and you stand before Him guilty, with no defense, then you're going to take a hold of the grace that Jesus Christ has offered you and the mercy, and you're going to hold on to it from start to finish.
Yes.
Amen. You're not going to trust in this flesh. Cursed be the man that leadeth to the arm of the flesh. Paul said that had you started, in other words, you started out in the spirit, now you will revert back to the flesh. No, the flesh is cursed. But I will tell you, I got life living on the inside. I've got a new life because I found the river of life. I found the lily of the valley. I found the bright and the morning star. I found everything I need, but I found Jesus. This faith that I'm talking about, where's your faith? It finds Jesus. Finds Him. Not only does it find Him, it accepts Him. In verse 22, and He said unto them, let us go over to the other side of the lake. The Bible said, and they launched forth. I don't have time to preach this in entirety today, but I'm going to try my best here. You'll give me about 20 minutes. Don't miss this. He said wherever He sends us, He goes with us. He said, let us go over. In other words, He promised to go with us all the way. Not just part of the way, just leave you. If you have accepted Him, He has made us, you and me, ambassadors. He's given us a commission. But He's telling His disciples, yes, I'm sending you among wolves. I'm sending you among those kinds of people there. You're going to tell them that I love Him. You're going to go and tell them that I will come to save them and set them free and tell them the good news of the gospel, that they got to know the state that they're in before they ever get a hold and accept Jesus Christ as the Lord and Savior of their life.
Yes, amen. Yes.
Accepting Him, Jesus gave them a commission. He said, all power is given unto me in heaven and earth. Go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them, not in the name of Jesus only.
Come on.
That's not what He said. I got a problem with these that want to baptize you only in the name of Jesus. Because they're not recognizing the Father, and they're not recognizing the Holy Ghost. I'm going to tell you, the Father had His day in the Old Testament. Jesus had His day when He walked here on earth, and the Holy Ghost has His day. When He is come, He will reprove the world of sin and of righteousness and of judgment to come. He's going to give Jesus Christ that the Holy Ghost is not going to come here and do something contrary to what this book says. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father except by me. In no other name has been given among men for my men to be saved, but through the name of Jesus Christ. If you accept any other, He cannot save you. He will not be able to stand on your defense when you stand before God. When I get to heaven, oh, brother, tell you what I'm going to say. If they ask me, say, why? How did you get here? I'm going to tell them all the call of Jesus Christ and Him alone. I've accepted Him as my Lord and Savior. He said this. He said, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I commanded you. And lo, I'm with you always. And lo, I'm with you always. It doesn't matter what storm comes along. It doesn't matter what you're going through. It doesn't matter what they tell you on television. Come on, somebody better help me. I want to ask you a question this morning. Am I throwing no stone? I'm trying to build your faith and let you understand things are going to get worse. And what you've got to have is a faith that rises above the storm and realize that Jesus Christ can stand up on the bow of your boat when you're about to cross over on the other side and take you by the hand and say, I come by to tell you, I will not have to cross Jordan alone.
Oh,
I'm feeling mighty good in my sanctified soul. Brother David, I'm glad I know the man from Galilee. I know the man, hallelujah. I don't just know about him. Anybody hear what I just said? And a lot of folks know about him, but they don't know him. You're not going to know it if you don't know His Word. That's why I try to tell you, get the Word of God in you. And whatever the tempter, you know, my mind got to get ahead of myself. I'll go ahead and say this right here. I just saw a text the other day of a guy saying, we don't need to tell people about Satan or sin or hell.
I want to tell you that that's what Jesus preached. He come to tell you, you got an adversary, you got an enemy that's going out to divide you. But he wants you to know your enemy. The only way to defeat your enemy is know who your enemy is. It is not your brother or your sister. If you wrestle out of that place of God, but the next paper pilot is a thing you can't see. But there's a God in heaven who is already defeated for you. And if you stand up on the wall of that hope, he can say, you, sir, be still alive.
Thank you.
He had a lot of good ball callers as long. She'd have that back on something really good hungry. And it cracked the corner, you sit down to the table, you said, oh, and with a lot of me, I won't tell you as good as that was when I came to a Lord of prayer and I found the Lord Jesus Christ and he became the Lord and Master of my life. I want to tell you, I found the one that can give me forever and tell me, show me whatever I needed, I had him.
Yes, amen.
I accept him. Woo. He's my Lord. I got hurt, I quit. I don't want to keep you here until 4 o'clock, but anyway. So Jesus here said, he said, let us go. So this, in other words, we're talking about a walk of faith here. And it's not only going to be finding God and accepting God, but you've got to identify with God. This is where the problem is coming in with a lot of folks today. The Bible says in verse 23, but as they sailed, he fell asleep. And there came a storm of wind on the lake. And they were filled with water. Mark 4 and 37 says, so that it was now full. So the boat's full. Matthew 8 and 24 said, now covered with lead. And were in jeopardy. Now all of those who tell you, if you just add Jesus to your life, he'll improve you or misleading their disciples. Now Jesus here did not come to improve your life.
Come on,
sir. Right.
He come to save your life.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
Well, you got to suppress that old nature. No, you got to crucify that old nature.
Yes.
Help me. So when you look here, Jesus said that if you identify with him, one must take up the cross and follow him. Jesus went on to say in Matthew 10 and 22, Mark 13 and 13, and also in Luke chapter 17 through 19, and ye shall be hated of all men. Some gonna hate you in church. You know why? Because you stand for the truth.
Amen.
I'm gonna do my best to preach to you the truth in love. But even at the best that I can do. And sometimes the little folks don't understand. But you know, if you get upset to me, you know what I'm gonna do.
Come on now.
I'm going to make you a king. I'm going to make you a king. So here, he said he would be hated, but there shall not, but this is what he said, but there shall not have, and I lost a few, on your head perish. In your patience, that's by your endurance, possess ye your soul. So Jesus never promised in the New Testament, to the New Testament, the church, that you would not face persecution, tribulation, even martyr, or be jailed, or be in famine, or peril, or naked. But Paul said, nay, in all these things, we're more than conquerors through Christ who loves us.
Yes,
yes.
So here, Jesus, those who are truly identified with Jesus, his written word, are going to face storms. One of the number one storms, one of the deadliest I know of right now, that's going on, it's not the right. It's not the pandemic of the Lord allows.
Come on now.
The deadliest storm I know we're facing right now is deception.
That's right.
Yeah, amen.
Let me share with you what I'm talking about. There were ministers to some ministers. I would go in there. I'm not trying to belittle, but I think they need to know. It was actually our MIP students. They had a preacher who come in, and this is what he said. When ministering to the unsaved or the church, you can't give them scriptures. Because, but that's not what Paul said.
That's right.
You're not going to be reading this for me.
Yes.
Anybody love me?
Yes.
I love you, that's why I preach it to you.
That's right.
I'll become your enemy because I tell you the truth. You know what Paul told young Timothy? He said, he didn't pass the tongue off. This is what he said to Paul. Or to Timothy. Paul to Timothy. I charge you before God and the Lord Jesus Christ. Preach the word. Be entered in season, out of season, approved, rebuked, or all on suffering. For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine. But he can himself keep his having his ears and eternal to the faithful.
Preach it.
Yes.
I want something fiction. I want something other real.
Yes.
can feel it in my soul.
Yes.
Amen.
This is what they said. They said because they'll have no idea what it means and will go over their head. Just tell me what God did for you in your story. Now, I want to say something to you. It's true. Paul told his story, but he did not exclude the scripture.
That's right. Amen.
When he sat before King Agrippa, did he not stand there and tell them the reason them of sin and judgment, those things to come? Say with me. Now that's a little bit of truth mixed in with some truth.
Yes, amen.
Anybody hear what I just said?
Yes.
Okay. It's true they had no idea what the scripture means. Because if the word is in, then they're lost.
Right.
So they have no idea what it means. And so they're blinded to it. That's why God called preachers.
Come on now.
Amen. If I had my regular brother Reuben, I'd have stayed in the college path. I love to raise God. Now I'm just letting me tell you something, huh? The college that I carried to the grocery store wasn't full of wormholes. You get what I just said? No, they were pretty and green. And when you come by, you were looking in college and saying, oh, I gotta have a lesson in college. Woo! I believe if us as Christians would let the light of the Lord Jesus Christ shine through us, and be somebody said, I've got to have what it is, ain't not. All right, let's go a little bit further here. Because Paul told Timothy to preach the word. Now, one of those students that sat in that class, listening to that stuff.
Come on.
This is what he said. We don't need to tell people about Satan, sin, or hell. We need to be preaching to them Jesus. I would agree we need to preach to them Jesus. That's why I'm preaching this morning. But the man that is lost don't know he's lost.
Come on. Amen. Preach it.
Amen. Nigga, he was young. And he said, I kept all these from my youth up. Well, the rich young ruler did. He said, I kept all these commandments from my youth up. But Jesus looked at him and said, no, but there's one thing you're
right.
Come on.
Right.
Wow. You hear what I just said? And so when I look at this, and so the thing that he said, I thought about this. The kind of road, they don't know what kind of road that they're on. That man that's lost, he needs somebody to show him where he's at. He needs to lead him out of that place. The young man must not know that Jesus preached more on hell than he did heaven. He must not know that the Bible says 2/3 of the world's population will go to hell. That's why. Why I'm still preaching the gospel. I didn't say to you the word in the Bible. He said for me to retire. Maybe one day I will. But as long as I feel like I can still throw my leg up and I still feel it directed and giving a message, I'm going to still cry out and tell people Jesus Christ. You can get up and preach your humanism out of if you want to, your opinion, but it ain't gonna save nobody.
That's right.
All you're gonna have in your church is a church full of tags. Mm-hmm. They ain't saved, they ain't born again. Let me tell you something, though. If you haven't turned from your sins and repented of your sins, you're still lost.
Amen. Let
me say something to you. Right here, I remember, I've heard a lot of preaching through the years. It's a powerful preaching. I remember Brother Ray Hughes. I'm just going to give you a case in point. He's preaching at a camp meeting one night. He said, one preacher said, I'm helping a homosexual through his homosexuality. And then all of a sudden, he came out with the scripture. What? He said, 1 John 3, chapter 2. Then I said, no! Are we the sons of God? And it does not yet appear. I want to tell you, when Jesus saves you, he does not leave you in your sins. He lifts you up out of your sins.
Yeah.
I know some of you are getting hungry. I hope you're hungry for the word.
Yes, amen.
But the kind of preaching, it should never be altered or changed, not because of the culture. There's a lot of preaching that's going on today. They changed the message. They say they're not changing the message. They just going to change the method.
Oh, come on.
But the method is the cross.
That's right.
Come on now.
Yes.
Come on now.
Let me say something to you. If you're going to follow Jesus, you're going to have to take up the cross.
Amen. That's right.
You got a cross to bear. You'll never get a crown unless you have a cross to bear.
Amen.
That cross. So you look at this. William Booth, this is what William Booth says. 100 years ago. In the 19th century, he said that there would be preaching forgiveness without repentance. That's where we are. That's where we are. But saints, the gospel is repent and then be forgiven. It's true that Jesus will love you just like he did the rich young ruler. But listen to this. He will never lower the standard.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise God.
But it is with the force right quick. Not only will you find Jesus and accept him and identify with him, you must trust him. In verse 24, and they came to him and awoke him. That identifies his humanity. They said, Master, Master, we perish. And in Matthew chapter 8 and verse 38, it says, Carest not that we perish? In other words, can't you see we're drowning? Now, I can tell you that's not a good feeling.
That's right.
I can personally tell you that. Because I can swim about like a rock. If you got that picture. When I was going to UCAP, not there in that pool, somebody pushed me off in the deep end. I didn't know what I could do but to hit bottom and keep going up and down and realize they can't swim. It's not a good feeling. So they come down, the storm is going on. And so here they could only see the impossibility of such a statement. I'm not minimizing the storm, it's real. And everyone that comes our way, well, I want you to understand, but to say that Jesus doesn't care comes from our humanity and our lack of understanding.
That's right.
And so here Jesus wanted to show them his deity, not only his humanity, but his deity. And so it seems clear that Satan, with the prince and power of the storm, I believe all this chaos that's going on is coming from Satan.
Yes.
And he's the one that caused the storm. And Jesus wanted, but he wanted his disciples to know, as long as he was on board, all the storms that come from Satan, the world, the flesh, cannot harm those who are in the boat, going with him to the other side. As long as you stay in the boat, you will be saved. Paul said, out on that sea, the boat's being torn apart. They got lifeboats just before we went, and they started to coast overboard to get on that lifeboat. And Paul looked at him and said these words. He said, except you abide in the boat.
Come on now.
You got to stay. You got to trust him through everything. I can't understand all that's going on right now. I just know the devil's behind it. Anybody believe that with me?
Yes, amen.
Come on, somebody help me.
Yes,
the devil's behind it.
Yes,
he is. The devil's behind it. We're a part of him. But you got to trust him when a storm comes. I believe all things are working together for those good. So those who are trusting in him will cry out. They will cry out to him. So are you crying out unto him today? We'll find that he who is ever interceding on your behalf in the presence of the Father that never slumbers or sleeps, now in his glorified body. In verse 24, we're talking about dust when he arose. I don't know about you, but I thank God there's an empty tomb. And he arose victorious. Hallelujah. He lives forevermore. And he rebuked the wind and the raging of the water, and they cease. Matthew 8:28-26 here, there was a great, that means a dead calm. Jesus is wanting you to understand. He wants you to trust him, to know nothing is bigger. Or there's no storm too big that he can calm.
Yes.
The last one I quit is His faith finds God and accepts God. And it throughout life's journey, it identifies with Him, His Word. It trusts Him no matter what kind of storm comes.
Yes.
Oh my. For the last that does, it holds. Would you do this with me? Verse 25. After He had rebuked the storm, He said unto them, "Where?" Say that with me.
Where
is your faith?
Where is your faith?
I want that to ring over to you this whole week.
Yes.
You're not supposed to just listen to it today and just let it slide by. Amen. You're supposed to go home and meditate on it. Amen. You're supposed to bring it back up like with a cub. You ever see a cow chew its cud?
Yes. Amen. Yes.
You ever see a cow chew its cud?
Yes.
It looks like a big old water stuff in your mouth. He brings it back up as food and he's hey. You're supposed to bring it back up and chew them.
Yes.
You don't know what I'm supposed to do? When you know, they have a preacher for another.
Oh, my.
Jesus.
God help us.
You're supposed to bring it back up and chew them. You know why? That's how we make strong in the Lord.
That's right.
By the word of God and holds through it. No matter what comes, He said unto them, "Why are you so fearful?" In Matthew 8:26, all ye of little faith. We're talking about the same storm.
Mm-hmm.
Not only for your faith, but there He said, "All ye of little faith." Mark saw it from this perspective. Why are you so fearful? How is it that you have no faith? So we identify where is your faith? Little faith and no faith. How many of you remember what we just said in the first part of the message, Hebrews 11:6? For without faith, it is impossible to please Him.
Amen.
And so here, I'm bringing this to a close. So we say we have faith, but in what? In who? Is your faith in Dr. Fauci? Is that how you say his name?
Fauci.
Is your faith in Dr. Fauci? Dr. Briggs? Now you're really quiet.
Uh-oh.
Preach it.
You're quiet as a mouse. Wow.
Preach on, brother.
I'm trying to help you understand things are not going to get better.
That's right.
And if your faith can't rise above this coronavirus,
Jesus.
You may be in trouble in the next storm.
It's true. Yeah.
I'm not throwing no stones at nobody.
Jesus.
It was a difficult thing for me 30 years ago when I stepped out in faith and went to Old Neil. I got a family and 2 children. But God has taught me some things through the year. If I will walk by faith and trust Him, He will take care of my needs. It is a walk by faith, not by sight. Those people that are up there telling you every day, they don't walk by faith.
That's right. Yes.
They don't. They got an agenda. One world order.
Preach
it. Bless him, Lord. Where's our faith? Is our faith in the news? Be careful. I'm going to go. I saw on my Facebook page, how many of you saw that George Bush was not going to be voting for President Trump? Anybody see that? Come on, raise your hand. I want to see how many saw it. How many of you know that's fake news? Wow. I read behind Bill Wilson, and I read him, and he said, "That's fake news." We gotta be careful what it is we're listening to.
Yeah.
Even the president, and I'm thankful for this president. Oh my, but he's just a man. I read behind, and so we see his own again. So just like this storm, when you look into the text, who was it that was causing the storm? It was Satan who started his inheritance and thought he could get rid of one of them. Said, "No, I mean, you can get rid of Jesus, but at least his disciples." I don't know that, but I know he's the one that was doing it. And if Satan didn't know it, he knows now. And Jesus has the power over not only demonic spirits and sickness and death, but He's got the power over the elements. Who is Lord of Lords and King of Kings can stand up and say, heaven and earth. He has the power to set men free from their sins and death. Hebrews 11:3, he is upholding all things by the word of his power. This coronavirus and all the rioting and all the unrest we're witnessing has not caught Jesus by surprise.
Amen.
Amen.
I may die next week.
That's right.
That's right.
But I'm not going to walk around in fear because I'm not going to.
Amen.
That's right. Amen.
That's right.
Amen.
Let me tell you something on the church. I was raised in a family of faith. My granddaddy had Bright's disease, I'm trying to close. An incurable disease. And the doctor said, you're going to die. He didn't know God from Adam. He come home and told my grandma, I said, I got too much sin to die and go to hell. That's the kind of faith I was raised in. He come home, got saved, sanctified, Holy Ghost still preached the gospel. And my granddaddy, when he got sick, they didn't have no money back there. You know what? Let me say something to you. Somebody said something to Brother Mason. He said, what would happen if we didn't have insurance and doctors? He said, we'd have more debt and more faith for them.
That's right. That's right. That's right.
Is it coming to the place? Is it coming to the place that God, you know, if my wife, Sister Carolyn, was to get sick, I couldn't be in the hospital with her. I can't imagine what Terry Hartley and those went through without there.
Yes.
I'm not trying to minimize coronavirus. It's real. Yeah. But also, I want you to understand Jesus is real.
Amen. Amen. Yes.
Amen.
I'm not here, Sister Florida, to throw those stones at nobody. I'm getting older. Anybody realize that?
Amen.
I'm getting older. I'm susceptible to pain. And all of the things that you're susceptible to, but I had a granddaddy that had faith in God, not healed of Bright's disease, but the doctor said, ain't nothing we can do for you.
That's right.
That's right.
Yes.
Where is your faith? I got told.
Jesus. Help us all.
Oh, Lord.
What they didn't know, I feel like I got to share this here with you. He's no longer in a bowl of sleep. It's true that you killed him for simply doing good. Let me say something to you. The worst nightmare comes to pass. Because when they laid him in that group tomb there, they never imagined or never even thought of. I'm talking about his enemies that he never rise from the dead.
Come on now.
They thought his disciples could come or somebody could come and roll that stone away and get him out of the grave. So they set a watch on him. We'll make sure that nobody gets him out of here, and then it'll actually be worse than he was the first time. But let me tell you something else. It didn't matter how many people they put back to watch it. People are the Lord's and King of Kings. And on that third day, they laid him in a tomb. But I want to tell you, it didn't roll the stone away so Jesus could get out. It was rolled away so you could look in and see. And he's alive. There's the Lord. He got out of the grave. And he's alive. Saddens me the most is because people have become so desensitized
They listen to Hollywood so much. They've seen so much that no matter what I preach or what I say, it doesn't affect them the iota at all. But I want to tell you what it's going to affect them. This is the only hope that I have, and I pray in this way that they at least get saved in the tribulation. Because they're getting ready to find out, Sister Faye, that this little preacher was telling them the truth. I want to tell them some fake news, some fairy tale, some myth. I want to tell you my God is real.
Yes, amen.
Thank you. You won't know it until the end. Yeah, I do. Heaven and earth may pass away, but not this world. Where's your faith? Or is your faith in what he said? Let me say something to you. Anybody wants your faith to be stronger?
Yes, amen.
Amen. If you want it to be strong, anybody want to have stronger faith?
Yes.
Let me ask you, how much do you read the Word?
Come on down.
How much do you read the Word? How much time do you spend with him? Sister Kim, when I was in the living room, I think it was on Thursday morning, I'm praying. Because I started on about Thursday, about the direction for the service on Sunday, praying for God. I had another thought in my mind there, and I just felt like Sister Carolyn, that the Lord just leaped out of me. I don't know how it's going to come out. God just gives me a direction. And then I step down and I start studying for about 6 or 7 or 8 hours. Wow. I don't come here to give you a little happy meal. I spend some time in the Word, and when I come, because I know what this book says, Romans 10:17, faith cometh by hearing. And if I want you to have faith, have where's your faith at? I want your faith to be in God. I got to get in the Word. I got to get in my faith, and I got to pray. And when I stand in the pulpit, that God's Word will seize in your heart. And when you walk out, you can walk at my Lord. If somebody get a hold of it, and you walk in the hospital, put a little bottle there, and believe it, God still heals the sick and raises the dead. We can walk in the hospital together and into the hospital.
Yeah, come on now.
It happened one night. They ran him out of the hospital because he was literally. People were getting up out of their bed in the hospital. Going home. And they let him out. They thought they won't have no customers. Woo! Ain't that wonderful?
Yes, amen.
Would you pray? I preached this morning. I prayed for God to save a soul today. Might be somebody over on the web page. But I pray for 1,000 souls, times running out. I want people to be set free from sin, Satan, the world, the flesh. I'm going to tell you, sin, I'm going to enter heaven. I don't know what kind of gospel it is that they're preaching. They don't preach that to my fucking head. Evidently, that young man don't know he's got an enemy. It's this new emerging gospel. It's not a gospel that sets men free from their sins. It's a God that they're offering to them that say he'll improve your life. It's adding Jesus to all of your other gods. It ain't gonna work. No, you gotta choose him. You gotta choose him. Will you pray? These altars are open if anybody wants to pray. Where's your faith? Where's your faith? Where's your faith? Is your faith in Christ? Is it in Jesus Christ? He's Lord, Lord. He's coming back after a bride.
Blessed be the name of God.
Are you ready?
Thank
you. Make your calling and let some sure tidings ring out.
Thank you, Lord, today.
It's time to get right with God. It's time to get right with one another. It's time for us to pray for our children.
Thank you, Lord, today.
Almighty God, mighty God.
Blessed be the name of God.
I feel the Lord in this place.
Thank you.
They wanted to move the old landmarks today.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God.
My Lord, you can't go to heaven with sin in your life.
Thank you, Lord Jesus. I ask you, Lord, to help us today.
It's time. It's time to be playing around with God. He loves you.
Thank you today. I thank you, Lord.
He died for you. He paid your debt. My Lord, what a Savior. What a Lord. This preacher loves you today. He loves you so much he comes out and preaches you the truth today. Well, I believe the Lord gave me. So never preach this in this way. I believe God gave it to me today. Facebook Live or you on the web, because God loves you. And if God touched your heart today, please let this little preacher know. Put a little thing there on that. Let us know. If you'd like to support the ministry, there's a place on that also. But that's not the most important. The most important is, are you right with God? It's time to get right with God and one another. Oh, my. Pray, church. Would you pray? If Jesus were to come today and you're here, are you ready to meet him? Are you ready to meet him? Faith finds God. Faith accepts him. It identifies with God. It identifies with him. Trust him. It holds to him. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Talk to him, church. Oh, mighty God, I'm reaching for people's souls. Anybody that will listen? I mentioned these Jesus. Those that are out riding in the street. I can understand the frustration of people. But I'm going to tell you, all the marching, all that stuff is not going to change the hearts of men. Only Jesus can change the hearts of men. He's the only one. He's the only one. Oh God, touch us today. Touch us, Lord. Touch us.
Thank you, Jesus.
I said he's coming for his bride. Yes. Oh, my.
me say something to you. If you've ever got along with God, and you've ever prayed, and you've ever been a witness for Him, let me say something to you. We can dwell so much on whatever it is that's going on that you can completely lose your joy. But Paul would say, listen, I've been trying to give you something to help you this week. He's in a Philippian jail, and he's writing to us a book. This is 30 years after his road to Damascus experience of Sister Faye. This is what he said, Philippians 4 and 8. Say this with me, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are good report,
whatsoever things are good report,
whatsoever things are honest.
There's
about six things, I can't remember them all, but this is what he said.
Think,
say that with me. Think all these things.
Yes.
How did Paul keep his sanity?
Oh, thinking all these things.
Oh, my. This is what he was saying in another place in the book. This is why I said in the word. He said, I reckon that the sufferings in this life are not worthy to be compared with the glory that shall be revealed in us. Just a little John Moore prayer. Okay.
As Pastor was speaking about things on Facebook that you see, you read, you don't believe, or you sort of share it, a couple of things this week that I found in the blogger. Reposted it. I went and checked it out, and I wrote back to him and said it's not true. But if you have seen the Facebook post about Barnes and Nobles, that they will no longer be selling Bibles for yada yada reasons, and it's been, people have been sharing it all through Facebook. There's a website called Babylonian Bee. They are a website, and everything I have seen from them is false. Nothing they print or put in publish is true. So I called and contacted Barnes and Nobles myself. And they said, no, man, that is a rumor. It is not true. We are still selling Bibles. So I think we, as humans, sometimes we grab at things, we see something, and say, oh, no, that's no, it's so negative, so they don't want to share it. We need to double check. But one thing I do know that is true that we have seen on Facebook. Sister Leslie sent it to me, and I checked it out as well. She has checked it out. And if you have not seen it, tonight at 6 o'clock, we will be having prayer here at church. And one thing that I will remind Pastor of, if you have seen this on Facebook, it's a Luciferian march for a one world government. They're marching next Sunday. In Raleigh, I think it's from 2 to 11 o'clock, 9 hours. And if you go and read that article, my God, church, we need to pray.
That's right.
They'll be going all around many cities in the United States,
yes.
But they're coming close to home in Raleigh. So we as a body of believers need to be praying. I'm not sure what all of them will be praying, chanting or praying for, but I know who I serve and whom I serve.
Yes.
And we need to pray. We need to pray for our government.
Yes.
Amen.
And for the citizens and for Christians to stand up. And but I do, if you want to just glance at this, I'm not promoting, I'm just telling you, church as a body, we need to be praying. And so you can look at this before you leave today if you just want to glance at it. But just keep it in the forefront of your mind that we need to be praying. Thank
yes.
you so much.
I want to say one other thing before I let you go, and the reason I want to say this is because of what she just said, to show you the power of prayer and the real child of God. I read a book some time back of a lady that was a witch that got saved. This witch, the praying like you're talking about, she was assigned to go to a certain place and pray. In other words, for the destruction or whatever of this Christian couple. And this is what she said. She said, every time that I went there to try to get to them, there was a fire on the way.
Yes.
that was surrounding him and he could not get through. That is what brought her to a saving knowledge of the Lord Jesus Christ. I come by to tell you, greater is he that is within me than he that is in the world.
Amen.
What do you say?
Oh, thank you, Jesus.
Don't forget, come pray with us. You can't come pray with us there in your home. I want to encourage you, we've got plenty of room to go around for us to church, social distancing, plenty of room for us to pray. If we never pray, you hear what I just said?
Come on now.
You never pray, we need to pray.
Yes, amen.
You're ready to sweat, but I saw one that I think we need to be a part of, those that can't. What Brother Andrew about stepping out, we need that. But I want to tell you what your greatest weapon is before you ever go out and start to do that. Is to get on your knees and be empowered by the Holy Ghost when you step out there. That you won't think about what it is you're going to say, but when you are there in that hour, the Holy Ghost will give you what it is you need to say.
Yes.
But it's going to come through prayer.
Amen.
Let's be dismissed in prayer. Brother Ruben, will you dismiss me?
Yes, Lord.
Lord, thank you, Lord, for this message, Lord, today, Lord. We just ask, Lord, that you just take it, Lord, put it in our hearts, Lord, and help us to have the faith, Lord. And we just ask, Lord, you keep it, take your hedge around each and every one of us today, Lord. Lord, that you would just be lifted up, Lord, in our lives, Lord. We ask in Jesus Christ's name. Amen. Amen.